4 is the time. This morning, the defense will continue to make its case in the Byron Smith murder trial. Prosecutors wrapped things up yesterday. Lawyers for Smith are trying to prove that he acted in self-defense when he killed two teens that broke into his Little Falls home. Yesterday, we learned that Smith shot Nick Brady 3 times with a rifle and shot Haley Kiefer 6 times with 2 guns. Kiefer. Joining us this morning is Christa Groshek with Groshek Law, where a little bit more analysis. You've been here this week, kind of been talking about how this case has been going on. And yesterday, let's talk specifically about some of this information that came out from the medical examiner. I think it's important to note that she had the cough medicine in her system, the marijuana in her system, and which has been something that the defense has been sort of trying to push into this case all along.
Right. The defense was told early on by the judge that he wasn't going to allow a lot of testimony about the decedents, the victims' histories, their background, the fact that, you know, sometime prior there was suspicion that they were stealing prescription drugs from another home. The court just didn't allow that in. However, when a medical examiner's report is offered into evidence by the state, the whole report comes in. And often what's tested is the condition of the person who's died. And with that comes tests to see what's in their body. So when they tested Kiefer's body, they found out that she was legally intoxicated. To me, that could mean a very low level of this cough syrup that was intoxicating, along with marijuana, which the medical examiner was clear to say that that would not have had an hallucinogenic effect on her.
Right.
So clearly that was at a low level. I don't think that's particularly relevant to the defense, because we don't have any evidence from that tape that she was intoxicated to a degree that she was aggressive.
Right.
She wasn't acting crazy. She wasn't loud. It didn't appear that she was getting big. So I don't think the fact that she was legally intoxicated on cough syrup really plays out in any way to help the defense.
Okay, so moving forward now, the big question is whether or not he's going to take the stand. It would seem to me that they would almost have to put him on the stand, but what are your thoughts on that?
If he was my client, I would counsel him very strongly to take the stand. I think it's really important for the jury to hear from his point of view what he was thinking, what he was feeling, what his background is. I think it's helpful to develop that, his military service, his service in the State Department. I don't think this self-defense can progress successfully without the jury being able to hear from him. I think it's crucial.
What would be the flip side to that then? What could the prosecutors do or say to sort of turn the tide against him?
Well, they'll have a chance to ask him questions too.
Right.
And they'll be able to go through all of those statements that he made both during the event and after, and they'll be able to cross-examine him very heavily about his use of expletives, the fact that he called them vermin, the fact that he had to clean up their mess.
Right.
I think that leaves him open to a whole lot of criticism, but it also gives him the chance to explain why he said those things.
Right.
And I think that's critical.
Okay, Christa, we appreciate your analysis this morning. All right, so I want to let you know, of course, we will be in the courtroom again today. We'll bring you the latest starting at midday, 11 o'clock here on 5 Eyewitness News, and 4:30 this afternoon.